Oh my God, it's Thomas the Franchise. If I die young, bury me inside, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river at dawn, send me away, away, send me away.
Yo, what is going down, y'all? As far as today's vlog goes, we got quite a few things going on. I'm gonna go pick up my NMDs from the post office. The pairs that I missed the other day when I was chasing the postman around all crazy. I'm gonna go pick those up, and then I'm going out of town. I'm gonna go stay with my boy Vitzer and his wife Mandy, and then we'll take a look at some of these NMDs. I'm probably not gonna review them all in one video because I wanna wear them and test out the comfort of the R2s, the pair with the tongue, the pair with the sock collar, so I can give you guys an accurate comparison if they're the same thing, if they're different, which ones to buy, which ones are more comfortable, all that good stuff. So that's what's going down today. Let's go ahead and grab the shoes, man. Dear professor, I've been in my room, think I'm going a little crazy, or maybe it's the shrooms. I'm addicted to the thrill, the dream of being big. I don't ever want to die, but I'm hating how I live. And it's getting so bright, these moments getting better, doing shows I never dreamed of. I want this shit forever in the city I came. The city done changed, everybody I knew saying I am not the same. We on the verge, baby, this the come up song, a little toast to the coast I done came up on. Get your camera, baby, that's a night for the ages. 20 years young, having fun, getting wasted. Take a look at this shit right now, y'all. This box is obviously like water damaged or something. Something happened here. Open it up. Dude, what in the hell is that, man? Come on, y'all. This paper is like still wet. It's like still damp from getting water damage. Wow. There's box number two. That looks fire. That's the heat right there. This is the only box that's like decent and it's still a little beat and water damaged. Unbelievable. They did throw in some Happy Cola gummy bears though. Neat. Dog. Let's talk about this for a second. I mean, obviously the box is water damaged and I haven't even looked at the shoes. I'm almost scared to look at the shoes. But come on, y'all. When you spend €475, that ain't working. These came from Alike or Alike or I don't really know how you say it. I think I've gotten one pair of shoes from them before. And I don't even think I can blame Alike. These were shipped by DHL and then they were passed over to United States Postal Service when they got to the US. I don't know why they don't just come here straight from DHL. I don't know what the issue is with customs or whatever, but this isn't gonna fly. I don't even know who I contact. The regular post office, DHL, Alike. I don't even know if this is Alike. I have no idea what this company is. I feel like I've ordered one time from them before and everything was cool. And that's what I'm saying. I don't really feel like it's their fault, but I gotta do something because this shit just ain't popping. Pull me out the bottom of this hole and it's getting so dark. These nights are getting longer. Hope I fall a million times just to stand up stronger. I don't wanna die yet, but fuck it if I do. Put your cup up in the air, bury me up in this pool. On the verge, baby, this the come up song, a loud toast to the coast I done came up on. Get your camera, baby, that's a night for the ages. 20 years young, having fun, getting wasted.
Just crushed.
I know, dude, isn't that absurd?
Oh my god.
Look at this.
it came. And when the postman gave it to me, too, he was like, I'm just letting you know, dude, this box looks pretty beat up. I'm going to go ahead and put a note in here in the system. So if you have any issues, you can file a complaint. So that was kind of cool. Yeah, but then once he said that, once I saw it, I was like, yep, it's probably not going to be good. And I got home to this. Like, what is that, dude?
This is probably the worst one, man. Look at that.
These two equally.
That was bad, too.
Dude.
Sucks though. I can't believe they tried to fit three in there too though. There's not like a lot of padding around the box.
There was this inside. That was it. Like this paper.
Dude, that's bound to get crushed coming international like that.
It was weird. It came from DHL and then it got transferred to the post office. Why didn't DHL just deliver the whole thing?
Yeah, I like those a lot, man. Which one should I wear today?
These ones were the ones that are most popping on sneaker news.
Yeah, but dude, these, Dallas was able to walk into Foot Locker at Park Meadows and buy those. That is
a little more soft.
And that's, plus these still have a brick on the outside.
Yeah.
These are the XR1s. When they put this on, they'll be the XR2s.
We wear them like that, but on 4th of July.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be fire, dude.
And then these ones have a tongue. So like these are just PK sock colors. That's the only reason I got these, because I wanted to test what the difference was. These feel a little lighter. No, maybe it's about the same. But this has the premium like your insole. But dude, feel how soft this leather is on the back, dude.
Oh, wow.
I know, it's like cowhide. It is. So soft. I was like, what?
Look at this leather right here.
Pretty dope.
Which ones do you like more?
Which ones are your favorite out of all four of these?
You gotta pick one for Thomas to wear today. You like
these
those?
Ones? These are your favorite? With those that hot red bottom?
Those are pretty dope.
The cowhide? Feel that.
Reminds me of like...
Do it with your thumb.
They should make bras out of those.
No, that so sweaty.
Should they make bras out of this?
No, so sweaty.
No, be so sweaty.
You can wear those.
Yeah, no, these are the same. The XR1s and that one are the same.
At work, right? Oh, okay. Or no?
Because these ones are suede. Glitches. It's like reflective on that one, though. These ones aren't reflective.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
You did?
Hey.
Perfect.
Which four of these do you think? Which one should I wear today?
Ask him, what are you wearing?
Oh, see? You gotta put the full outfit together.
I will build the outfit around the shoes. I'm in Steve Harvey mode.
Don't you worry about what I brought.
You ain't running nothing up in here.
You pick the shoes. I pick the outfit.
Which ones did you say?
I pick blacks. What'd you pick, Addy?
These ones?
Those.
And Addy picked these ones? And you say these?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Easter is like a light color.
It's not black?
As I say. I'm black and
blue. And you're black and navy.
But my kids are in Easter colors.
We don't care about ourselves
anymore. As long as the kids are...
As long as the kids are good, we're all good.
We're running around naked, but our kids are dressed up nice. I don't know, man.
It's tough, huh?
The XR1's just too nasty. I just like that silhouette, man. I don't know what it is. Man, you don't like it as much.
It's alright. I've noticed that a lot of them look better, like, when you actually see them. Than
you know what
I did?
She didn't like the sock color.
Yeah, well, because
like on
there,
on the
uncaged, like
on the uncaged Ultra Boost and on these, she's like...
I saw it on the...
Snapchat?
Yeah.
Fire, huh?
I just can't believe that they didn't put any padding, dude.
Oh, yeah. Those are...
See, the blues are...
Dang, dude, there's so much boost in that thing.
Does it feel different?
Yeah.
Are those like 3.0 boost, or is it different than that?
I mean, these are mad comfortable. They're not as comfortable as an Ultra Boost, and I would still probably...
Did you ever twist your ankles in them, like I did this morning?
Dude, I did when I was playing that game the other day, that foot golf. Yeah, I booted a soccer ball in these and twisted my ankle so bad. Oh, those are fire.
Those are dope, dude. See, babe, look. On feet, they look way different.
Yeah.
Super dope.
Mommy. I don't know if I would like how high that comes.
This?
Or on the front.
Feels like you're wearing boat shoes. We're getting the wave pool with these joints on.
Remember
the one with in the city socks. In the wave pool.
Dude, you're gonna have a collection of city socks.
I could see you getting some city socks, dadding it in the wave pool with the shorts pulled up. Yeah.
That's the worst.
I can see it, bro. You're a city sock kind of guy.
That's for Dallas, man.
Dallas is a city sock kind of guy.
Dallas is on the city sock.
Oh, I hate them. They're so gross.
Dude, that was probably one of the funniest reviews I've seen, because you're just sitting there all quiet.
Oh, the kid ones?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I didn't know about the shoe. Dallas was all Dallas.
Probably I have to change shorts, too.
I'm giving you shoes. I really am not a fan of those black shorts anymore.
I'm skipping it.
I actually am shopping for you.
Have three.
Well, because they're not black. Those things have been worn so many times, they're not even black anymore. They used to be black.
That's why I throw the gray on with them.
Right. Yeah.
It's not like they're all faded.
Yeah, I was going to say, wear what black shorts? Where's black? I don't see no black shorts.
You can still wear that hat with either of them.
Ultra Boosts are way more comfy, dude.
They're insane, huh?
I've never put one on.
Those don't even look that big.
big on you.
It's because of the prime name.
Dude, those are just
I actually
unreal.
Do like these ones better on than those, and originally I told them I liked those better.
You like which ones better?
This one.
Ooh, but these are 10 times more comfortable.
Dude, these are probably one of my favorites.
Dude, it's weird.
These in the, I just like the black and white, like salt and peppery.
Yeah.
Those uncaged ones too that Tim was wearing, those are just.
Yeah, those are sick, huh?
Feels like I'm floating.
Dude, if you had, you need to get it.
You need to.
I've got to get a pair, dude.
My arm hurts. So what shirt are you wearing?
Dude, that's just unreal.
I know.
How comfy those are.
I know, I'm telling you.
Are you mesmerized?
Because he was editing the vlog. Actually, I think this happened a few times.
Yeah.
Last weekend, too.
I still haven't done my taxes.
Oh, stop.
What did they do?
Did you file?
On,
the
18th, yeah, Tuesday.
Oh.
Is that your taxes really easy?
Yeah.
Yeah! Yeah, they are.
We're taking my car. I did wax it, clean it. How's that song go?
What?
That song.
Wax it, clean
it. Da, da.
Oh, that is so bad.
I don't know that one.
Yes, you do.
You're talking about touch it, bring it, babe.
Wax it. That's why I was like, what's she talking about? Wax it, clean it.
Wax it, clean it, babe.
That might be the worst I've ever heard. Wax it, clean it, and touch it, bring it?
Yeah, it's kind of the same.
How did you even get that?
This is what I deal with every day.
How'd you even know she was talking about? That's why you guys are married.
I'm addicted to the thrill, the dream of being big. I don't ever wanna die, but I'm hating how I live. And it's getting so bright, these moments getting better. Doing shows I never dreamed of. I want this shit forever in the city I came. The city done changed. Everybody I knew saying I am not the same. We on the verge, baby. This the come up song, the loud toast to the coast. I done came up on. Get your camera, baby. This a night for the ages. 20 years young, having fun, getting wasted.
Long time no see.
Hey, how are you?
How you doing?
Good, how are you, man? But we're all alright. I'm the greatest. I'm the greatest, baby. I'm the greatest.
These fit smaller than the R1s. Like these fit. These are true to size. These are at 12, and they fit perfectly. I feel like if I size down these, they would be way too small.
See the thumb. Look at that.
I know, they'll just get roasted.
Getting...
They used to look really dope when they were out of the package.
When they were out of that beat up package, they look sick.
That's what this record everything on.
Oh, is it? Oh, I thought you were doing it with your phone. Sorry, I thought it was pretty good.
You think the quality would be that good off the phone?
I didn't know. Do I look like I'm...
Steve's about to be boosted.
Oh, we got it.
Dude, I guarantee if you put on a pair of Ultra Boost, he wouldn't want to wear anything else. Especially how he is with comfort and stuff.
Yeah.
Just like to be comfortable. If you put a pair on, it would be Overtown.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
You ever been to a little place called Overtown, Steve? We're about to take you there. Throw on some boosts. Overtown.
A little place called Overtown.
Well, it's 316, so give me a hell yeah.
Okay, Austin.
Stone Cold Steve Austin, 316, since I just ripped your ass. Give me a hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
All right, it's getting a little cold now.
No, it feels good, dude. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, it's perfect.
Oh, come on, bud. Just a little nip. My nipples aren't busting out because my chest hair hides everything.
You got extra padding.
The Italian chest hair. Just,
that's so gross.
It's not gross.
I think it's gross.
It's not.
I don't like the way it comes out the top of the shirt like that.
Why?
It's like into the neck.
Ladies do though.
I'm just... Yeah, it's definitely unique how it tickles the bottom of your chin.
No, it's not that dry. I think it's fine. And no, I'm not ever shaving it again.
No, I know you're not, just because I give you shit about it. Just that'll be the reason that you know, in like the missionary style, you just like grab
no,
it.
No, she doesn't grab it like that. It's like this. I'd be like, lay like, off the hair.
Hold on for the rest.
No, if she was grabbing the hair, I'd be hurting.
It's too fun.
Another decade where there's a couple burnouts and we're the only ones left. We'll figure it out. There's a couple burnouts. We'll get it together. No worries. Drunk, you know where we're home.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Raising that.
Drink them up. think you've had enough cakes.
That's what she said. She said you had a margarita over there and got a little lit.
A little bit.
Sleeping in your bed.
Yeah, go get a bottle.
No.
And Steve was busting over the table. Okay.
Not me.
What's up, though?
That's definitely making the vlog.
Do you know
Dan? Steve, come on, help me up again.
Push it with your feet.
You gotta push with your, push with your back.
There you go. Oh, with the... I thought for sure I was going down. Oh, shit, you're just doing the most.
I was like, just, I know.
It's like a little bit is too much, and then like...
Hit these right here, man. Hit these right here.
This is good.
You just gotta pull them out like that, and it locks them.
And then a beat drop.
It's about to be the heat. I want something just like...
Alright guys, I'm back home, and before we even get into the review or taking a look at the shoes, let's go over the melee that happened yesterday. You saw we got the NMDs, the boxes were water damaged, the shoes were all good. All the shoes were in good condition. It's just the boxes that are water damaged, which is still water damage. I mean, if I wanted to sell this shoe, I'm not gonna be able to sell that on StockX. If I want to trade this to someone, they're probably not gonna take that and have that be acceptable. So for anyone that says, oh, the shoes were fine though, they're not water damaged, yeah they are. The box is part of the shoe. If you collect shoes, you know how important the box is to the shoe. The shit is water damaged. So I'm in contact with the post office. We're getting a claim going. We're getting it all worked out. Yesterday, I was really, really heated about it when I was talking to you guys. I calmed down. It's not that big of a deal as long as stuff gets handled. I did pay a lot of money for the shoes. I expect them to arrive in proper condition. They did not, but we're getting it all taken care of. With that out of the way, let's get into the shoe. Start you off with the box label as always. These are the NMDs I wore today, so these are the ones we're going to take a look at. Damn, these are a lot worse than I thought. These are really grass stained up, and I don't really have time to clean them because this vlog has gone long enough. I don't even know if these grass stains are going to come out of the shoe, but whatever. Bang! There you go, man. You guys see the grass stain? Yep, there you go. Look how wicked that is. It's in the PK, too. Backside of the boost. Just not good overall. I have a couple different methods I'm going to try with these grass stains, and if it works, I'll show you guys what's up on another video. And if it doesn't, I guess these are just beaters after the first wear. But let's get into the shoe. This is the NMD R2 PK Runner. Let you guys look around the shoe. Really, really dope colorway. Navy and red together always gets me. I love navy. I love red. Those are probably my two favorite colors. So when they put them together on a shoe, I always have to have it. I love this colorway here. I'm not wild about the R2 pattern. It's cool, but I still prefer the glitch pattern of the R1 like this. I don't hate it by any means. I just like the glitch a little bit better, but this is still cool. Like, it's different. They got to switch it up. They can't just be dropping glitch the whole time. But when you look at this R2, the first thing you notice, if you're familiar with R1s, is the massive amount of boost here on the R2. Like, let me just put it side by side. You guys can just see how much more boost is on the R2. There's just so much more boost on this one. In addition to that, you see there's no longer bricks on the outside. You got those bricks right there. There's no longer those bricks on here. It still has the stripes in here to kind of represent the brick, but they're missing. They're gone. But on the inside of the shoe, they've stepped the brick up. It's a huge brick on the inside compared to this one here. So they did away with the outside one and they just got it on the inside now. But aesthetically, that's the first thing you notice when you just look at the shoe, is the massive amount of boost and the missing bricks. The first thing I noticed when I picked them up, and you guys probably saw this a few vlogs ago with Dallas's, is how soft this boost is. This R2 boost is extremely soft. I mean, you can feel it when you push on the bottom of the shoe. You can feel it. You can feel how soft the boost is on the R2. The comfort is definitely a lot more noticeable going from an R1 to an R2. The boost is more noticeable. The boost is more prevalent. And that was a lot of people's complaint about NMD R1s, is they just weren't that comfortable. A lot of people hype boost up and then their friend goes and gets the R1 NMD and they're like, what the hell's the big deal? Instead of going and getting like an ultra boost or something like that, that's gonna live up to that hype. And I've had friends that did that. I try to tell people all the time, like, just cause it's boost, it doesn't mean it's the comfort of an ultra boost. An NMD R1 is nowhere near an ultra Ultra Boost Comfort. This gets a lot closer. It's not Ultra Boost Comfort, but it gets a lot closer. This is like Yeezy V2 type comfort. I would compare the comfort on this shoe to like a Yeezy V2. Very, very similar. Not necessarily in fit, but in comfort. They're both a tier below Ultra Boost, but I'd put this R2 and the Yeezy neck and neck. Let's get into the Prime Knit as you take a look at that massive grass stain on the toe, my lord. But anyway, this Prime Knit is, It's really, really stretchy. But the Prime Knit on the R1 was pretty stretchy. The glitch pattern was not a huge difference, but I would definitely give this the edge. It is a little bit more stretchy in the Prime Knit. Not insanely, but just a little bit. You might notice it, you might not. Here's the thing that bugs me about the Prime Knit, especially with this pair. It's how it looks stretched out. You see that? Like, how it just looks like the navy is stretched out and the white is just peeking through. And it was like that when I pulled them out the box. This may even look a little worse because I was running around all day, cutting in the grass, dancing, doing everything. So this is a good indication of how the shoe is probably gonna wear just by your natural wearing it. And over time, the Prime Knit is gonna stretch out, especially on this blue pair. I think it'll probably be the same on the black pair or any of the darker colors. I don't think you're gonna have that problem on the red pair because it's just fully dyed. With this one, the blue is dyed, but it's just as your foot gets in there, it kind of stretches it. Like when I put this shoe tree back in, you'll be able to see this kind of represents your foot. That's how it's gonna look on your foot. Kind of stretched out, kind of bugs me a little bit. Witzer and I were talking about that earlier. It's not really a deal breaker for me. Like, I don't want the shoe. It's just something you're kind of like, eh, all right. And don't get me wrong, some of you fools might not care. You guys know me, I'm picky. I'm picky about everything and every aspect of my life. So I nitpick the shit out of things, from my shoes to my food to my lifestyle to my girls. I probably won't get married until I'm 70 and I probably ain't gonna make it to 70. I'm just a picky guy. This may not bother you like it does me. There was a ton of people like talking about the Havens and all the stuff that bothered me. It didn't bother them. Cool. I'm just showing you the things that bother me and the things that I did or didn't like about the shoe. Same thing here. You guys might be fine with it. As we move around to the side, you've got the three stripes. It's kind of like a ribbon type material. It's not reflective. You got the solid blue laces, and that's something that I was super, super pumped about when I saw this shoe, is that they had four lace holes. So I was like, yes, they gave us four lace holes. They didn't give us three. I was really excited about that because I thought maybe we'll have a chance of not having to tie the shoe. No. They just went ahead and made the lace 4 inches longer. Thank you for that, Adidas. So as you can see, I still had to tie the shoe. I just tied it up like this all day. I may mess with it and try something different, but for now, the laces were just way too long. If I don't want to tie them, I'll still have to lace swap them, is what it is. It was something I was excited about, and then when I got the shoe and I saw they added the extra lace length, whatever. Moving along, if you're subscribed to the channel, then you know how we do it, and you're probably a baller. Sock collar, 20-inch blade on the Impala. And the sock collar on this one actually does look a little tighter than the R1. You see that there? I mean, I don't know. It's just, maybe this is because this one's worn. I'm not positive, but it does look tighter. I didn't really notice it like squeezing tighter or anything on my ankle. I was wearing really thin no-show socks with shorts though, so I'll have to kind of update you guys on that, but I didn't notice it squeezing any tighter than the R1. I found the R1 very comfortable. I didn't really notice much of a difference on this one as far as the sock collar. Moving around to the back, and this is kind of where they went hybrid on it. This is an XR1 pull tab and backing. This is the old R1. They got the plastic heel cup with the pull tab. On this one, you got the suede here, and then you've got the pull tab going through the suede, just like on an XR1. This is the glitch camo XR1. You notice we've got the pull tab in the back. This one is a reflective material. It's not suede like this, but it's the exact same design. Moving to the inside, you see they went primo with the leather insole on the inside. Still does have Boost. It's just stamped into the leather there. Very nice touch on these. On the outsole, you've got the translucent bottom there. Mine's very, very grass stained, but it does look super, super nice when you first pull it out the box. Actually, there's my red pair. That's what it looks like when you get it out the box. Obviously, this has the red on the bottom, not the black, but you can see it will get stained up, but it does look really fresh when you first pull it out the box. Now, the last thing I want to get into is the fit of the shoe. This does not fit like a PK R1 NMD, like this. I'm not talking about mesh NMDs. Don't bring that into the conversation. I'm talking about this right here. PK, sock collar, this fits way different than this. This is more of an honest, true to size fit. This is a 12. I put my foot in it. It's perfect. It's snug to my foot, true to size. That's it. You guys know that on my PK NMDs, I always tell you I put my Ultra Boost insole on the inside. So as you can see on this pair, I have the Solar Yellow Ultra Boost insole. I just put that in all my NMDs. This is a size 12 as well. I can put my size 12 Ultra Boost insole in. It's money. On this one here, it fits so snug. Not even snug, but it just fits so true to size that when I put my Ultra Boost insole inside, the insole doesn't really fit for one. It's kind of like the Havens where it like has that bounce to it. Also, it makes my foot bulge out of the top of the prime knit. My foot is looking like that in it because of the insole. It just pushes it up too much. If I would have known that, I probably would have bought a 12 and a half just because I like to wear the insole for my Ultra Boost on the inside of my NMDs. I think it makes the shoe more comfortable. That being said, this shoe is more comfortable than the R1 NMD, so I don't mind as much without having the Ultra Boost insole inside. It's still a comfortable shoe, but personally, if I could do it again and on my future pairs, I will definitely go up a half a size. I will get a 12 and a half so I can put the Ultra Boost insole inside and be Gucci. Still very comfortable without it, but that's just something I do. I always rock my Ultra Boost insole inside my NMDs. This pair, I'm not going to be able to do that because it's too much. So all you guys that usually go half down on your PK NMDs, I would not half down on this. I would go true to size. Again, I have a bigger foot with a size 12, so maybe that's different, but that's how I felt with this. If I went a half size down, I feel like it would just be way too small. The other thing I did notice as far as the fit on these, after wearing these all day and running around and cutting and jumping and all that stuff, I had like a massive aching in my left foot. I don't know what happened. It just got like a cramp in the arch. And it was funny because someone said in the comments that they really could feel this R2 brick underneath. I never really thought I could feel it all day, but maybe I could. I don't know. I just kind of had, my feet were just kind of aching after I took the shoe off all day. And I was so happy to just slip into my Ultra Boost and I felt back at home. This is obviously a lifestyle shoe. I was running around all day in them. I was cutting. I was doing a lot of stuff. I wasn't just chilling. If you're just walking around at the mall or you're just walking around a normal day, I doubt you'd have that issue. But that's just something I noticed in them. The shoe is still really comfortable, but athletically or running wise, I wouldn't recommend it. It's just a lifestyle shoe. It's just to walk around in. It's not to be doing a whole bunch of jumping around and dancing and grass staining and whatever else, because my feet were hurting by the end of the day. That's about it on this pair, guys. That's all the differences between the R1 and the R2. Some of the differences you can't see, but some of the things I noticed. I'm really, really sorry about the grass stains, but you guys saw it all. You saw what was going down today. But I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I hope it was helpful for you. If you're looking at getting a pair of these, if you're trying to make a decision on whether or not to buy these, I hope it showed you some intricacies that you maybe couldn't see in pictures. So as always, if you guys enjoy what I do, please hit the thumbs up button. And if you haven't already, please join the rest of the best by subscribing to the most underrated sneaker channel on YouTube. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you fools tomorrow. Yeah.
Gotta do it like you told me. I'm only getting old. I've been sitting on my hope, just waiting for